So the first thing that you have to see is form patterns. So over here, we'll see what form patterns are, what are the various types of pattern. There's a form pattern report. We'll see that. Then we'll see how to apply a pattern, how to apply a sub pattern, and we'll see some properties. So the first thing that we have to see is what is a form pattern. So we saw that we have various types of forms available in finance and operation. So over here, whenever I'm talking about forms, so we know that we have a table, like if you remember table of content, one was simple list, one was details. So we have various types of forms available. So form pattern is what Microsoft wanted, that whenever you are creating a form, the form that you are creating should be like, it should be familiar to the user who has to use it. Okay, so if a person, like if say, let's say that if I'm a person who is familiar with finance and operation, then whatever form you are creating, I should be familiar and I should know how to use that form as well. As in, I should be like, let's say that you, I'm an Android user, then you will create an Android UI so that I'm not confused. Obviously, if you'll provide me an iOS UI, I'll get confused. So that is why we use form pattern. So over here, it basically has what? Over here, form pattern is first of all guided approach that helps me in guided development. That is, if you recall, we had a template, like we had a box where it was mentioned that I need to add this, like I need to add the action pane, I need to add the group, I need to add the grid. So over there, everything is guided. So it's not like I have to use my brain or remember anything. Everything is being guided. Secondly, it is consistent, as in every form that is of, let's say, details, the detail list or simple list, it will have the same design. So it's very consistent. And obviously, it is easier for us to upgrade such forms because we already know the pattern and it's easy for us to apply the upgrade. So they are compatible with the upgrades as well. And last one is, over here, we have multiple default control properties. Over here, we have various types of forms that I can use. So by default, we have various types of forms that we can use. And for every form, we have various kinds of properties. So in some, you will have grid. In some, you will have list. In others, you will have tabs. So every one of them have different properties. Then over here, they are saying that these are the five, like over here, they have mentioned five types of form patterns. Let me do one thing. I'm so sorry. So, Durian, if you recall, I have shared one document with you.
Right.
So, if you access that document, I have. Like I've attached the types of forms over there so that you can understand the forms from that. So I'm opening the document. Just give me 1 second. So, Durian, over here, I have shown some form patterns. So, this is how a detail master looks like. Over here, you see the list of items. And if you click on the item, it will take you to detail. So, this is called a detail master. In detail master, what we have, we basically have a primary source of place where I can see the all of the information. If I want to get more information, let's say we are seeing this information about the customer. If I want more information about this customer, then I will have to click on it and I'll go into a detailed view where I can see all of his information, like what is his payment information, his general information, so I can see this. Is it clear, Durian?
Yes.
So this is what is detailed master. So I've in the PDF, I've attached this, don't worry. So over here, what I can do, I can see the information, then I can go in depth, I can click on it, and I can go in depth of the information. So this is what is detail master. Form part, you are already aware of it, that over here, we have a site tab where I can get the information, like this related information. So this is what, this is form part or fact boxes. It is used to provide additional information so that the user does not have to open another form and he can get the information on screen. So this is what is fact boxes. Is it clear?
Yes.
Then we have simple list. Simple list will only provide me a list. So this is a simple list where I can see all of the items as a list. So it's just a simple list that I'm getting. So it's kind of a simple list that is being displayed inside a grid. Then we have table of content. If you remember, I showed you this one. So it's like where if you click on this, you'll get the details related to this form. If you click on shipment, then you'll get shipment related forms. So over here, table of content is used whenever I have to add multiple, like I have to logically link multiple forms together, or I want to display more information together, I'll use table of content. So this is what is table of content. So you can have a look and let me know once done.
All right.
Just let me know once you have seen it.
All right.
So then we have operational workspace. If you remember, I told you workspace is a place where I can see every information on a single screen. So this is a workspace. Let me show you the same on the front end as well. Oh God. Just in a while, it will get the up. So I'll show all of these like all of these pages on the front end as well, so that you have an idea over there. It should be up in any minute. Okay. So over here. Okay, so let me just go into the basic page. So I'm going to show all of these to you again. So if you remember, I started with the simple, like, let me show you a detail master. So detail master is where? Detail master is any, let's say, vendor customer form, you'll see detail master. Why? Because I get the basic details over there, and if I click on the basic details, I can drill down. So over here, this is the basic details. If you want, you can click on the vendor account and it will take you into depth of this vendor. That is, you can see all of the information about the vendor. Then we have form part, which is the information that is additionally shown on the right, like on the as a box at the corner of the form. So this is form part. Apart from this, we have simple list. So if I go to the groups, so this is the simple list where I can see all of the vendors as a list. So I can see all of them as a list if I want. So this is what is a simple list. So this is a simple list. Apart from this, we have table of content. So I showed you you don't have to remember the navigation. You just have to focus on how the form is.
All right.
So this is how a table of content looks like, where multiple informations are accommodated on a single page. So this is table of content. Apart from this, we have workspaces. So if you navigate to this workspace, you can see a workspace, like this is a workspace. So this is a workspace where all of the information has been accommodated on a single page. So these are the forms types. So there are multiple. These are just five type of forms that I have shown. There are multiple types of forms available. Obviously, like whenever you'll be working on a real-time project, you'll understand those over there. Any doubts in any one of them?
Nope, no doubts so far.
Okay. Apart from this, we have sub-patterns. If you remember, whenever we added the group over there, I was again asked to apply a pattern. Do you recall?
Yes.
So on every form, we can add pattern, and inside the pattern, I can add sub-pattern. So it's the style is same. Again, the pattern unspecified will be written, and you can apply form pattern. So we have these types of form patterns. These are the types of form patterns that we have. Let me show you what each one of them is. So this is why I have sent you this, like this book, so that it's easy for you to understand. So the first one is custom filter group, the one that we use. It is used to apply filters. So I can have one or more than one filters over there. It is not mandatory to have one filter. I could be having multiple filters. Like right now, we just added one quick filter. That is why we only saw one quick filter over there. If I would have added multiple, then multiple quick filters would have been visible over there. Is it clear? So this custom and quick filter is used to apply filter. Don't worry, you have this document. Then we have fields and field groups. Now what people want is, whenever they are displaying the information, they want that the information should be displayed as a group. Like this is an aisle, this is a level information, this is a position information. So they have grouped them together. So this is done using the fields and field group sub pattern. So it is doing what? It is kind of creating a container where you can add the, where you can specify the group and add the fields related to that group. So this is what is fields and field group. Then we have image preview. So image preview allows me to display information and show the information. So that is what is an image preview. So you can add the image and that will be visible to the person. So this is what is image preview. Then we have tile. Tile is used whenever we are creating a workspace. This is majorly used inside a workspace. So whenever you create a workspace, you can use tiles over there. Is it clear?
Yes.
Okay. So these are the types of works, like sub patterns that we have. Any doubts in any one of them?
No.
Okay. Now this is where we, like we have, if you remember, we had a property called view edit mode, which I specifically had demonstrated. So if you have view edit mode, if you let it be in view, then whenever the user is coming, the form will always be in view mode. That is the view button, like over there, the page will not be editable. So it until unless you are clicking on the edit button specifically, then until unless you are clicking on it, then only it will be in edit mode, else it will stay in view mode. In edit mode, it will be in always in editable format, and you can save the, you can basically work on the data, you can edit it and you can work on it. So this is what is view and edit mode. Do you remember this? Do you want me to repeat this one?
I remember.
Okay. Apart from this, we have allow create, allow edit, allow delete. So let me show it to you. So over here. So over here, do you see allow create, allow delete, allow edit? So it specifies whether I'm allowing the user to create a record into this database. I'm allowing him to delete the record into the database. So if you remember, I told you that forms are used to either get the information or display the information. So whenever I'm using form to display the information of DB employee table, am I allowing the user to add a new information using the form into my table? Am I allowing him to delete the information that is already available in the employee table using the form? Am I allowing him to edit it? So these properties you can specify from this place. Is it clear?
Yes.
So this is what has been mentioned over there. So over here, it is like whether you are allowing him to create. If you say no, then the user will not be able to create a record. He can only view the record. If you enable it, then the user will be allowed to create the record and then you will see the new button. If you allow delete, then you will see the delete button and you will be allowed to delete the record, else the delete button will not be visible. So this is what is allow delete. Now over here, they are saying, they are talking about the form pattern tab. Let me show you what the tab is. So over here, this is the form pattern tab. So this is the pattern tab. As soon as you click on, let's say a pattern, then the pattern tab comes into play. So this is a tab that guides me on how exactly I can apply a pattern. So this is the tab that they are talking about. So why do we have the pattern tab? Why do we have a pattern tab?
For guided development.
Okay,
for guided development. We're missing things. And to let us know when we're missing things.
Yes, perfect. So over here, we basically are having pattern tabs and they are helping us in developing the solution. So it's kind of guided development. That is, we won't be missing anything out and we know what has to be done after what. Then it ensures consistency. That is, all of the forms that the users are having are similar, are consistent. That is, they are not missing out anything. So it's like it is allowing me to have guided development. It is consistent. And it is also, it's like I like the user is also comfortable with the UI. It's not completely new to the user. So that is why we have this form pattern tab. Now, it also notifies us if there is any error over there in the form or not. So over here using this form pattern tab, I can know whether I have made the correct, like I have designed the correct form or not. Or if is there any like scope of improvement that is required? Is there something that I'm missing or not? So these are the things that the form pattern tab is doing. Now, form statistics. Now, whenever you design a form, so this is my form. Whenever I design my form, I have a tool over here. We have a tool over here called form statistics. So whenever you design a form, you can open this tool, form statistics, from the D365 menu, add in and form statistics. It will let you know how exactly have you applied the form. So it will basically let you know the percentage, the statistics of how exactly you have applied the form. How many data sources you have, how much percentage of the task you have completed. That is, if I've added only one, then it will say 25% of the form pattern has been applied. If I've applied two, then it will say 50%. Then if I apply three, it will say 75%. If I apply the form pattern into custom filter, then it will say 100%. So that is what is the task of form statistics. Just a second. So this is how a form statistics look like. So it is mentioning that all of the details are mentioned over here, that we have these number of forms and these are the forms that we have. For simple list, we have 1547 forms. For fast tab, we have 204. For standard tabs, we have these number of forms. So this is form statistics for all of the forms. As well, I can also see the form statistics for my particular form as well, where I can see how exactly whether my form is like, is it up to the mark, as in is it completely done or it has some specific areas that requires your concentration. So I can see the form statistics for my form as well. So it will take some time, give it some time. So it's not coming, then I'll show it to you on the front end as well. So this is how the statistics look like. So it's not coming onto our form. So it is like over here, you'll see that all how many data sources we have, how many methods I have overridden, what is the pattern coverage, how much pattern have I applied, and how many controls I have. So I can get all of the information, which pattern I applied, how much I have applied it. So it's kind of a statistics that is being provided to rate whether I have completely applied my form or not, and it's providing me information about the form pattern that I'm applying. So over here, I can see pattern name. I can see the percentage of how much pattern I have applied successfully. Like if I'm missing something, then the percentage will be reduced. So it's kind of a statistics of my form. Then we have form pattern tab. You are already familiar with this. Tell me one thing. What if like I add the action pane first, and before action pane, I add the group. What will happen?
It would break because the order matters.
Okay, so the order is very important. Without the order, it cannot work. So if you're adding first, like if you're adding action second, then it will throw an error. So over there, it will mention that action is missing. So it's very important to follow the sequence. As well, if you're not adding something, then you'll find missing over there. So if you add something extra, you'll find error over there. So this pattern tab is guiding you with everything. And with this, we are done with this module. Your questions?
True.
True.
Table of contents?
Yeah, table of content.
Let's see, it's A, B, and D.
Okay, perfect. A, B. Yeah, correct. All of them are actually covered by the form pattern, form statistics. This one? Okay, I'll show you this one. This is like, they have not specified the definition, but they have added the question. So I'm letting you know. So over here, we have one functionality. If you click on the D365 add-in, we have one functionality called Run Form Pattern Report. So if you run this report, it will download a CSV file. In that CSV file, you can see what forms you have and what are the pattern the form is having. So I'll show it to you. Just give me 1 second. So this is the pattern reports. If I open it, you'll find that inside we'll have the list of all of the forms in finance and operation. So these are the forms that we have over here. So I can see all of the forms over here. I can see all of the forms, and then I can see what pattern has been applied to these forms. So I can see the pattern. So if you want, you can put a filter. Let me show it to you. So I can put a filter. So let's say you want to see what are the forms with, let's say, detail master pattern. So I can select detail master and I can see that these are the forms. Like over here we have HRMS application. So these are the forms that have this pattern. So I can get all of the information. If I want other one, let's say I want the list. So I can select list. So I'm selecting list page. I'll click on OK. And I can see that these are the forms that have list page. So it is kind of a report that is providing you all of the information of how much percentage you can get, all of the information, like what is the coverage, what many controls you have, what pattern we have applied. So every information is available inside this report. Is it clear?
Yes.
Okay. So going back to the question.
True.
Or, okay.
No, wait. I don't think that's a CSV file. But
pardon?
Was it a CSV file or a regular Excel file?
CSV file.
It was a CSV file. Okay.
Yeah. Now with this, we move on to the 10th module. So in the 10th module, we'll create a form. So here we'll talk about creating the form, adding the data source, adding the controls, and we'll apply patterns and apply sub-patterns. So over here, we will talk about the certain things. So first is form design. So design is the place where you are applying the pattern. So the first node that we saw over there was design node, and that is the main node where we apply the pattern. Let me show it to you. So we will have to move here and there again and again with this one. So this is the design node. This node is the design node. Is it visible?
Yes.
So this is the design node that we have, and it is used to apply the pattern. Let me just. So that is the design node. Then we have groups. So I can group things together. I could group field together. I could group the buttons together. Do you remember button group? Over here, we created button groups. So we have button groups over here in the action pane. So that is a group. Then we have tabs. Do you remember tabs? I'll show it to you if you do not. So over here, I will open the customers. Just a second. And let me open the customer over here. So these are tabs. Do you remember them?
Yes.
So these are tabs that they are talking about. So tab is basically, you can have multiple tabs and you can add multiple information inside the tab. Obviously, where these tab and tab, so inside tab, you add tab pages where you add the fields, or if you want to add fields, you can add the fields. If you want to add image, you can add the image inside the tab page. And button group is a group of buttons where I can add multiple buttons. So it's kind of a container that we use to store the buttons. Any doubts on any one of them?
No.